CPQ, or Configure Price Quote, is a great tool that allows Salesforce users to customize their pricing processes to fit their own specific use cases. In this video, we'll take a closer look at one particular piece of CPQ functionality, known as percent of total pricing, and discuss how to solve a big issue you could run into while using it. So first off, what exactly is percent of total pricing? As the name would suggest, percent of total dynamically calculates the price of an item based on the total cost of all the other items in the same quote. For example, let's say we are an electronics company and we want to offer a hardware support package to our customers. Since the amount of work involved depends on the amount and complexity of hardware purchased, percent of total pricing is a natural fit for this product. So we can see here we have a simple product for the hardware support package. This product is configured with the subscription pricing set to percent of total, and our percent of total value is set here to 25%. Now this process works well for larger orders, but we maybe don't feel like it's worth our time and effort to provide support on smaller orders where the percent of total may only be, say, $20 a month. So one way to solve that particular issue is to use a percent of total constraint, in this case, a minimum. So essentially, we would come up with some number that's our minimum amount that we think is worth our while to provide support for a set of hardware. And you can see here we have this set to list price is minimum. This basically just means whatever price book we're using, it'll have a list price set for this particular item, and that's what we're going to use as the minimum constraint for this item. So we can see here in our price book, we scroll down, we have the hardware support package, and we can see just for the example, our list price is $200. That does not mean that it will always be $200, but rather that the price will always come out to at least $200. So continuing our example here, let's say we have an opportunity with an account called CB Consulting, and they want to purchase some video equipment from us. So we have this first quote here, containing some items that they would like. So let's say we started out with five each of a set of a 4K video camera, camera mount, microphone, headphones, and then one hardware support package for the entire set. As we can see here, the price of this is set to a quarter or 25% of the net total of everything else on this quote. And so if we were to say that the company, CB Consulting, the person that we're talking to maybe isn't the decision maker. They're the tech guy, and they say they need five sets of equipment. And so we give them this quote, say, hey, what do you guys think about this? The IT guy gives it to the big boss man, and the big boss man says, I don't want to spend that much money. Let's just buy one set, and then you guys can just all share. So we will change our quantities here down to one for each, recalculate, and we see here that this new total amount, which is much smaller, would bring us below our minimum amount for our percent of total line item. And so we see it defaults here to the minimum constraint of $200. So let's go ahead and save this because the boss man gets what he wants. Only one set and everyone gets to share, and hopefully they don't share too many germs. So now with this quote created and set up correctly, what we are going to do is turn this opportunity into a contract, which if you don't know, we basically just need to check this little box here that says contracted, click save, and give CPQ a quick minute here to work its magic. So we now see here we have a brand new contract created with that quote. You can see here for that opportunity. And with that being all good and well, we send that off to the big boss man who signs it, and we're all good to go. So now let's continue our scenario here and say that we head home and go to bed happy for making the sale. And then the next afternoon, we get another call from CB Consulting with an interesting turn of events. Turns out that the employees at CB that morning voted to unionize, and the union's first demand is to have more recording equipment. They don't want to share, and you can't blame them. So you congratulate your contact on their successful collective bargaining, and you set out to amend yesterday's contract. And here is where we start to run into our issue. Now, when we amend a contract, we are basically creating an additional quote. However, as you'll see here, this new quote has references to everything that was on the original quote. But since there's currently no differences, there is no price difference either. There is no additional cost on the amended quote currently compared to the original quote. So let's go ahead, go in here, and change our quantities back to 5 and calculate. And now we'll see that the price difference for 4 of the video cameras, 4 of the camera mounts, 4 of the headphones is all calculated over here in these net totals. However, the hardware support package doesn't seem to be doing anything when we click calculate. As you can imagine, in situations like this, that's a significant problem. This is going to lead either directly to lost revenue or indirectly through requiring sales reps to manually calculate things, which would be time consuming and error prone. So we want an automatic solution to this problem. So to fix our problem, we first need to understand the cause of the problem. Essentially, Salesforce CPQ out of the box just doesn't support amended quotes with percent of total constraints, which is what we have here for our hardware support package pricing. And so rather than allowing CPQ users to run into confusing or inconsistent results in cases like this, CPQ basically just checks for any items like this on an amended quote and then just sets the list price to 0. So our approach will be first to override this default zeroing out behavior, and then to add in our own proper method of calculation. So first, to get a bit more specific about what exactly triggers this default behavior. At some point in the calculation process, CPQ checks each of the items in a quote to see if these three conditions are all true. First, it just checks if the quote is an amended quote. Second condition is that the line item uses percent of total pricing. And the third condition is that the line item also uses a price constraint. In other words, and this ends up being important, it has either a minimum or a maximum price attached. So if all of these conditions are met, CPQ zeroes out that item's price. So one way to avoid this behavior is to use a price rule to simply remove any price constraints from items on a new amended quote before CPQ has a chance to zero everything out. So if we want to look at our price rule here, we can see we have a price rule clear maximum and minimum list amount, unit price on amendment POT lines. And basically, for our price conditions, we are checking to see here if the quote is an amended quote. We are checking to see if the subscription pricing is percent of total. And then we are checking if either it has a maximum price or a minimum price set, in which case it uses a percent of total constraint for the pricing. In such cases where these conditions are all met, we then have two price actions that essentially clear out the minimum and maximum price field. So we get rid of that to avoid triggering CPQ's default behavior. Now, don't panic. These constraints still exist on the original line item, which we can go back and reference, and we will, just not on the new line item. So now that we've circumvented CPQ's default behavior, we can add in our own method of calculation. Luckily, CPQ makes it relatively easy to extend its functionality through the use of plugins. So if we look at the installed packages, go to Salesforce CPQ and configure it, we see we have a tab here for plugins. And there are a variety of different plugin options here. And you can find more info about any of these plugins by going to the Salesforce CPQ developer guide. And you can see they have a list of different types of plugins, as well as different examples of how to accomplish different things through using one of these plugins. So the one that we are going to be taking a look at and using for our solution is the Quote Calculator plugin, which you can see here will be a JavaScript code. Once we have that, we can just stick it in here, and it'll run every time the quote recalculates the price of something, which is exactly what we want. So unfortunately, this part of the solution is going to be heavily dependent on the way that your particular org is configured. So I can't provide a one-size-fits-all script that you can just throw in there. However, I can briefly go over a code snippet excerpted from one of our solutions to this problem. So we see here we have this quote calculator plugin excerpt. And the main things I want to point out about this is that firstly, that our script is going through a particular quote and is running through each line item and running this code for each one. So what is this loop doing exactly? Basically, it is overriding the setter for the list price property, which if you're not familiar with JavaScript or other languages with setters, basically a setter is a chunk of code that runs every time you try to assign a value to a variable or attribute. So anytime the list price is assigned to the line item, rather than just automatically the list price changing to that value, we have a function that takes in that new value as a parameter and then does a bunch of stuff with it. So again, this is going to be dependent on exactly what fields you have on your objects and different constraints and things in your org that you need to meet. Earlier up in the code, we used SOQL to query all of the prior quotes and store that data in the aggregated subdata attribute. So anytime a quote is an amendment quote, it has a reference in one of its fields to the original quote, is what it's called, which is just the previous quote. So using those, even if there are sort of several layers of amendments where you amend it, save it, and then you don't have to go back and amend it again, you can follow those original quote references all the way back and aggregate all the data you need using SQL. This data from the original quote, we can pull out the minimum and maximum unit prices for this particular item. And again, this is applying to every item in the quote. And then we can also calculate our own total list unit price based on the quantities in the original quote and in the amended quote. We can then compare our calculated price with these constraints, and then further compare this pricing with the amount that was already included in the original. So that way we are only adding the difference. And so we either are, you can see here, setting the list price equal to that difference, or we are setting it equal to zero if there's no additional cost that should be involved. So as you can see, you'll need a developer to create and customize the script for your particular organization. If you don't have a developer or would like to consult with us on our approach to this solution, please feel free to reach out to us at dbservices.com/contact, and we will be happy to help.